program director with Route 50. I'm here with Bruce Katz from the Brookings Institution and Doug Deather, who recently published The Public Wealth of Cities. So did I get it correctly?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Don't want to mess that up. Now, you all just came from talking with the Large Urban County Caucus here at the National Association of Counties. What were some of the themes that you were providing to the members there?
So the conversation was very much about how cities and urban counties in the United States are now basically responsible for financing the future. The federal government has left the building. Many states are hostile. So the way we've been thinking about this, and really the thesis of Doug's book, is that cities and urban counties own an enormous amount of assets, real estate, land, buildings, operational water and sewer authorities, and in other parts of the world, essentially in Northern Europe and in Asia, cities are leveraging those assets to finance infrastructure and pay for other public goods. They have a systematic approach to what Doug calls public wealth. And in the U.S., we tend to sell off parcels one by one, or we have public entities that manage it within tremendous rigid constraints. This is a different way for cities and urban counties to discover and then leverage enormous amounts of potential wealth for public good.
Now, Doug, I know this is an issue you explore a lot in your book, so how do we do this in a manner that allows for prosperous returns for